Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming out tonight to the Lakeshore Theater to see me talk. That's what I'm going to be doing. This is going to be... I don't know how much stand-up comedy you've seen in your life, but it's pretty talky. And, like, that's what I'm going to be doing is... Like, there's... You saw... Please, another round for Drew Michael and Dan Telfer, who were out here earlier. These guys are funny. Like, you saw them, and they were talking. And then... I'm going to be up front with you. I'm going to do the most talking. You might find yourself saying, those first guys, they talk, but then they knew when enough was enough. And then this guy... It's like, doesn't he get it? How many times can I look at my watch? Or nudge my girlfriend? Like, don't we have to go meet some people? I guess what I'm saying is you're going to be bored. That is... I care for that weird shout out to boredom. Please forgive me while I unscrew the cap of my Voss water. Yeah. Voss is my favorite because it looks like... I like to pretend I'm drinking shampoo. Oh. It's an acquired taste. I don't think you would enjoy it. Like, I'm a very sort of evolved person, so I've gone beyond traditional beverages. Now I enjoy shampoo. I love the consistency of it. So much better than other drinks. I tell you what I hate is conditioner. It's like the cilantro of things you should not drink, but do. What? That concept got off the rails. Did not have a good example of what to call those things. I could not figure it out. There should be a category for drinks that you're not supposed to drink, but you do because you're more highly evolved. And smart drinks has already been taken, and people have already stopped drinking them. That was a phase that we are not in anymore, when there were these kind of cider drinks. Like, there was, you're supposed to be smarter if you drank them, that they were going to give you some kind of boost of intelligence or something. And now they just cut to the chase, like, energy! It'll make you feel like you're on drugs! All right. Thank you. Was that so hard? Nobody's trying to feel smarter. We do want to feel like we're on drugs all the time. At work. You can't actually do drugs at work in front of people. You will get, at the very least, yelled at. Right? Even if you work at the coolest place in the world. You hear those stories about Google, where it's so cool to work at Google. It's so laid back. And they got video games and shit or whatever. Even there, if you did like some lines at your workspace, I'm sure somebody at the very least would go, hey, come on. What more do you need? We got arcade games here. Do you have to do rails at work? Boy, oh boy. I'm not even going to get into the healthcare, which is great. Which I think that is somehow an abuse of, by the way. I'm not going to pay for your rehab. Because you can wear a t-shirt to work. That's the slippery slope, though, folks. Is that once you're allowed to wear a t-shirt to work, the next thing you know, people are doing coke right at their cubicle. Like, what? Explain to me how these aren't connected. There's a lot of mixed signals here. First, I'm allowed to wear a colorless shirt to work. Then all of a sudden, I'm not allowed to blow at my desk? Maybe this should be written down somewhere, even though we don't like to write stuff down here, because it's so cool.